I'm going to use the standard normal table to find the probability of getting a z-score greater than negative 1.5. This is also going to be the area under the standard normal curve from z is equal to negative 1.5 to positive infinity. So sketching that, drawing a reasonably bell-shaped curve, okay, emphasis on reasonably, the z-score is negative, so I will be putting that below zero. And because it's greater than, I want to shade to the right. Now, using the standard normal table, the table that reads from negative infinity up to z, what it's going to give me is it's going to give me this little tail here, but that's not what I want. So to get around that, I'm going to use the fact that the total area under the curve is 1 or 100%, and I'm going to use the table to find this unshaded tail first and subtract it out. So this little tail area that's unshaded, I want to subtract this area out. In other words, I'm going to subtract it from 1. So in notation, this is going to be equal to, this upper area will be equal to 1 minus the probability z is less than negative 1.5. So again, I'm taking the whole thing, which is 1, and subtracting out the piece I don't want. And the reason why we have to do it this way is because of how the table reads. The table reads cumulatively left to right. All right, so going to my standard normal table, reading down to negative 1.5, okay, so that would be negative 1.50 on this table, so negative 1.5 and then over to 0.00. That tail region will be 0.0668. So this is 0.0668, that little bitty tail. So 1 minus 0.0668 is equal to, grabbing my calculator real quick, is 0.9332. So in other words, we shaded about 93.32% of the area. Now looking at what we've shaded, this answer makes sense with respect to how much is shaded. I expect the area to be greater than 0.5 because I've shaded well more than half of the area under the curve. So if you left your answer as 0.0668, hopefully you would recognize that that answer is not consistent with how much was shaded.